defending Confederate symbols, cottoning to some people with ugly ideas, none of that kept Corey Stewart from getting the endorsement of the President of the United States and more votes than the rest of the GOP field in the primary for the Virginia U.S. Senate seat. No small feat. Stewart, who served as the state director of Donald Trump's campaign for part of 2016, seems to be part of a new movement within the GOP. So, what exactly does he represent and whom does he represent? A lot of people are talking about him tonight. Let's test him directly. Republican Virginia Senate candidate Corey Stewart, welcome to primetime.
Hey, thanks, Chris. Thanks for having me on your show again.
All right, so let's put up the president's tweet here about you. Congratulations to Corey Stewart for his great victory for senator from Virginia. Now he runs against a total stiff, Tim Kaine, weak on crime and borders, wants to raise your taxes through the roof. Don't underestimate Corey, a major chance of winning. Why do you believe you won the primary?
Well, I won the primary because I'm a strong supporter of President Trump. He's a very strong. He's got a great, a story to tell, improving the economy, the lowest unemployment record rate since the early 1970s, and now a big success in the foreign policy front as we remove the nuclear threat from North Korea, something we've been living under for several years now. So my strong support for President Trump, and plus the fact that Republicans are looking for a fighter, somebody who's going to kick the teeth out of Tim Kaine.
And it's what kind of fight you're going to fight, right? Let's play a little bit of the message you had for the masses.
Or it can choose the past with everything we know that has failed. And that's Hillary Clinton's running mate, Tim Kaine. That might just happen, by the way. And Timmy, too.
Lock up Tim Kaine. You're a lawyer. Do you really believe that Tim Kaine should be in jail? Or is that just a Trumpish joke?
I'll tell you something. I really do believe that Tim Kaine has been at the center of all this stuff that you're seeing with regard to the FBI. You know, the whole problem is out of the FBI spying by a federal agency on a presidential campaign.
No proof of spying. Continue.
There's no proof. We're not in a court of law here, are we?
Well, that doesn't mean the truth doesn't apply, my brother. Try
well,
to stick to it
something.
On this show.
It started with Democrats in the Commonwealth of Virginia, and Tim Kaine is right at the center of this. I would not be surprised if there's an investigation of Tim Kaine before the year is out.
You wouldn't be surprised, but you have no reason to believe it. What I'm asking you is, what are you selling there? Tim Kaine should go to jail. They're spying when you have no proof. Are you selling people on things that aren't true but will make them angry? Is that your vibe?
What do you think? That the Virginians are just a bunch of naive people that, you know, will believe anything? Look, at the end of the day, here's the question that people have to ask themselves. What has Tim Kaine accomplished in his 6 years in the United States Senate? Tim Kaine can't point to a single accomplishment in the United States Senate for Virginia or Virginians. The only thing that Tim Kaine has done over the past 6 years is run for vice president, and he didn't even do a very good job at that, I might add.
All right, now look, that's a fair political argument, and he'll have to answer for it. It's different than saying the guy should be in jail and making up, you know, rumors about there being spying. One is factual. One is just an ugly feeling. You know, now Kaine can defend himself. Here's what he has said about you, by the way. He called you a cruder imitation of Donald Trump who stokes white supremacy and would be an embarrassment for Virginia if elected. That's what his spokesperson said about you. And he does seem to be getting an echo effect within your own party, Mr. Stewart. The former lieutenant governor of the state of Virginia said, I'm extremely disappointed that someone like Stewart could win the Republican nomination for U.S. Senate. Clearly not the Republican Party I once knew, loved, and proudly served. Every time I think things can't get worse, and there is no end, they do, and there is no end in sight. Then you got Gardner, who is a big shot when it comes to the Republican Party and who they pick for Senate, and he said this.
Look, we have a big map, and right now we're focused on Florida, North Dakota, Missouri, Indiana. Big map, and I don't see Virginia in it.
Senator Gardner, not giving you any love. The former lieutenant governor within your party, no love, but Trump giving you love. Does this mean that you are the party that President Trump wants to cultivate?
Well, Gardner and the others, look, they're going to come around. We, they've done a lot of hurt feelings. I beat their guy. but they didn't support President Trump back in the day either. What's happening, Chris, inside of the Republican Party is that the party is changing. It's becoming the party of the little guy. Once upon a time, it was the Democrats who claimed to be the party of the working man. No longer. They abandoned the working guy. They slammed the door in their face. And now it's President Trump and the new Republican Party that is supporting working Americans, blue-collar workers. That's why we're winning states like Michigan, Wisconsin, Ohio, and Pennsylvania, and we're about to take back Virginia as well.
That's why Trump may have won them, but I'm talking about you. And you seem to be cottoning to a very specific brand of humanity. And you're right. It is a little guy that you are being a part of, but it's a little hateful guy. You have a well-pronounced past of saying that you agree with and that you like people who push ugly, bigoted, intolerant, and racist notions.
Hey, that's a level of lie that's just not true, Chris. Even for CNN,
level of lie that's just not true.
Even for
CNN, is there any level of lie that is true?
That is not the case.
I'll make the case to you.
I have always condemned, including on your program,
yes,
any white supremacists or bigots or anything like that. We want nothing to do with that.
Have you?
But that's the only thing that you and the left have. You claim you play the race card every time because it's the only thing you have. The president has a success of bringing back
an
economy,
the lowest
unemployment rate
right now
in 40 years.
This is about you.
That's what I'm
supporting. And who you have represented as your friends, heroes, and like-minded individuals. Put up the fact sheet here. These are the facts, not about my feelings, okay? This guy kneeling, and I'm not going to give him too much attention because he doesn't deserve it, okay? 2016, he shares tweets defending an anti-Semitic Twitter user. You knew that. And yet, in January 2017, you called him your personal hero.
That is not the case.
It
now,
is absolutely
the
case. I have the proof of it.
Are you
going
to let me get a chance to respond, or is this all about you?
No, it's about the facts.
Is it about me, or is it about you?
You got to live with him. Go ahead.
Well, yeah, but you're not giving me the chance to respond.
Go ahead,
respond. Typical. This is typical for you.
Respond.
So here's the situation. You know, everybody supported Paul Nehlen. President Trump said nice things about Paul Nehlen. Sarah Palin did. Ad Coulter. Laura Ingraham. A lot of us. The late Phyllis Schlafly did. And then all of a sudden, after all that, then about a year later, then, you know, he says, you know, Paul Nehlen starts coming out with all these terrible things, those anti-Semitic things, those terrible bigoted things. At that point, we wanted nothing to do with it. We all distanced ourselves from him. But
not
back
true.
In the day, he was not like that, at least
not
as far
true.
As I knew.
Put back up the timeline. Not true. Demonstrably false. Here's the facts for the audience. Okay. Nehlen then writes about Islam not being a religion of peace and a lot of uglier stuff that I didn't want to put out there for the audience, okay? He then talks about the then governor of South Carolina and calls her something in an ugly way. Nehlen then retweets 9/11 would have been a wonderful day without immigrants. And then what do you do after that? You give him money for his campaign, okay?
That is not true at all.
Then
look,
only
here,
later,
is,
when he takes it another step and you decide that you want to reach out to people who may not share your like-minded
Chris,
bigotries,
you know
then
you're
say
doing?
You're denying him.
You're
what
assuming,
do I have wrong on the facts? There's the timeline.
Everything. I don't agree with any of those things.
You don't have
you
to agree with it,
said.
But can you deny
do you,
it?
Do
can you disprove
before
it?
Before you say nice things about anybody, do you look at everything they've said in the past?
When
do
they're
you?
Talking about bigots
now, the fact
and
you're
anti-Semites?
To, you yes. and Tim Kaine and the far left are trying to change the topic
the
from
left.
The fact that this president has been successful.
It's not about the president.
That, he's going to bring me and the other Republicans across the finish line, and it's going to be a red tide this November.
Listen, maybe it will, maybe it won't.
It will be.
But you represent something different, okay? You have
I just told you what
to
I represent.
You've cottoned to a
I'm
man
the world's
that the facts
foremost
show.
Expert on what Corey Stewart believes.
Well, but
and I just told you I don't believe
you
in any
call
of those
somebody,
things that you just mentioned.
Why did you call somebody who is an anti-Semite and
so
an obvious bigot your
Chris,
hero?
Let me ask you this question.
Yes.
Okay, are you going to have Tim Kaine on this program?
If he'll say yes.
Okay, all right. So you ask him this question. Has Tim Kaine asked Tim Kaine whether he condemns Antifa, a domestic terrorist organization that attacks people
Listen.
For their political beliefs, of which his son is a member?
Answer
and yet,
for
on the
you,
CNN of the far
and
left,
he will answer
you will
for
completely,
him.
And you never ask those on the left, the far left, that's like Tim Kaine.
Look, that's not true. We've had this conversation before, and it's never been about that. It's been you trying to play an equivalency game to get away from the bigots that you cotton to.
You just showed the facts. You never condemn the
extremists on your side.
I have condemned the extremists on the right time and time again.
Forget about the left. Forget about Trump. Focus on you, because he picked you. He likes you. He likes what you're about. And I want to talk about what you are about, because this guy, Nealon, isn't the only one in your past. Now, is he? You also cottoned to somebody else named Hines. You took his endorsement. This is the guy who took the shot at Nikki Haley, saying, our Sikh governor. By the way, she's not a Sikh. This is the man who took a Confederate flag and marched down, saying that a statue of Arthur Ashe was offensive to his heritage. You backed him. You've never denied him. Why?
You know, I don't agree with any of those things that you said. The thing is, what you're trying to do, Chris, is deny your past,
but it's there like a big, ugly shadow, Mr.
You're trying to change the topic by the fact you're always playing the race
just
card.
Just the facts.
You're
that video was you in front of a Confederate flag taking
his endorsement.
By the way,
your own father said anti-Semitic things. Did you ever condemn
please.
Him? That's true.
My father is dead and buried and was 10 times the man you'll ever be on your best day. So
stay comparing yourself to the bigots you never want to condemn the extremism on your own side of the aisle.
There is none
and I
on
have
my
condemned
side of
that
the
extremism
aisle. My aisle
time
is the truth.
And time again.
I am a journalist. Was that a Confederate flag that you were just in front of taking that man's
you
endorsement?
See,
yes
look,
or no?
You know what? Let me tell you something.
Yes or no?
You want to condemn everything that's happened.
You can't even answer the question.
You want to condemn Southern heritage. You want to condemn everything. You want to take on
monuments. I don't
want to
condemn anything except
hate. None of that helps anybody.
And lies.
None of that
helps
anybody.
Okay, you tell me. How does a statue of Arthur Ashe offend your idea of Southern heritage?
I never said it did.
Hines did.
Chris,
and you never said he was wrong, did you?
Chris, I don't agree with that statement.
Then why didn't you ever say that?
How many times do I have to tell you what I believe?
Why didn't you ever say it?
Why don't you ask me what I believe? And I just told you I don't agree with any of that.
Say Hines.
This is the guilt by association that the left always plays.
You're in front of a Confederate flag accepting the endorsement of a known hater.
You have never. Have you ever condemned Antifa?
Mr. Stewart.
Well,
whether I
the question,
had
Chris,
or I hadn't,
have you
two
ever
big
condemned
points of fact.
Antifa?
One,
has Tim
that's
Kaine
irrelevant.
Condemned
and two,
Antifa?
I'm not running for public office.
So it's irrelevant for
am
me,
am I running
for
Senate in Virginia? Do I want people
look,
to accept
to,
me
you know what?
As their designated leader before Congress?
You're trying to change the topic. The topic
no,
is
you're
the economy.
The topic.
The topic
you're
is
trying to
back
change the topic and deny the facts.
The topic is making the world safe in the Korean Peninsula, and people are sick and tired of the far
I'll
left
tell you
like
what
you
they're sick of.
And Tim Kaine always trying to change the topic.
I'll tell
what
you what
Americans
they're sick
truly
of.
Believe in.
You are the topic, my brother. You are the topic. And here's what you need to do. Here's my suggestion. You do with it what you will. Own what and who you are. Obviously, the Trump team knows who you are, and they like you. Don't run away from your past. Don't run away from the things that you obviously embrace.
You know, this is
own
such a joke.
Of
even
who
for
you
CNN,
if you want to be intolerant
CNN had to
and
fire
be a
you
bigot
even you,
and be in front of the
so
Confederate flag
above what is honest,
but why
is
can't
unbelievable.
You be honest?
You are part
why can't
and parcel
you just
of the
tell
campaign.
The truth?
He ought to report
you.
You
haven't denied
as
a single fact that I've suggested, Mr. Stewart. Do you know that? Did you take his endorsement, Mr. Hines? Yes or no? Did you take it?
I take support from whoever wants to give it to me. That doesn't mean I support their views.
No
matter. That does not mean I support their
so
views.
So you think that you can
I
take the support of somebody.
Anything to do with anybody who's racist
hold
or bigoted or anti-Semitic.
Hold on. Hold on a second.
I'm the world's foremost expert on what I believe, and I don't believe any of those things that you're trying to accuse me of believing.
I just want to repeat what you just said. First of all, of course there's guilt by association. Don't associate with known dirtbags, and you won't be guilty of doing that, okay? That's your problem, not mine.
Why
but you just
you
said, I will accept the support.
How come you haven't condemned Antifa? I don't understand.
Hey, bigots,
it's a domestic
anti-Semites,
organization.
Anti-Semites? White supremacists? Those
you
have
know,
a nice way of describing
party.
Them. But
hey,
hold on, you just
way.
Said something, Mr. Stewart.
Way,
I want the audience to hear this.
By the
hold
way,
on. Hold on.
Wait, whoa.
Hold on a second.
You're talking
I want
a lot.
The audience to hear what
little.
You said.
Let me just say,
I will accept the support of anyone.
You're not
it doesn't mean
to
I accept
me
their
talk,
views.
Chris, this is what well, yeah, the Chris Cuomo show. I mean, you talk all the time.
That's why
that's
it's called
Chris
the Cuomo
show
is. Because if you're not going to answer the questions,
of you talking.
You're not going to get to just yammer on this show.
That's what you're doing.
But I'm trying to get you to confront the facts.
You don't even listen to your guests.
Hey, listen. I've listened to what you said.
Do you know that the Democratic Party nominated an anti-Semite in Virginia? How come last night, the Democratic Party nominated an anti-Semite in the 5th District, Congressional District in Virginia, and you're not even reporting that?
Who?
Why is that?
Who? What are you talking about?
She was nominated last night.
I'm talking about you. I'm talking about you, Mr. Stewart.
How
does anybody else?
We have an avowed anti-Semite Democrat.
There is no avowed anti-Semite anything except the one I think I may be speaking to right now.
Put that on your show tomorrow night. You might learn something.
Hey, look, I'll tell you what.
That you have extremists on the left, and you're not doing anything
about them. I'm happy to look into that, but I want you to answer some questions for a change, all right? Don't blame me for being extreme left or being some Antifa fool.
Chris,
that's a joke.
You don't deny that you're a leftist.
It's your attempt to
you
deny,
don't deny you're a leftist.
The facts.
I mean, this is the biggest joke I've heard in a long time.
But you think that's a big joke? Wait until what happens on Election Day if you don't own what you really are. Because the only way that you have a chance of getting any kind of positive momentum is if you're truthful about who you are. The record is clear. The record is
coming
clear
from CNN
about you.
Talking about truth, that has got to be a joke.
You tell me what I've said that's untrue. Did you call Nealon one
you
of your heroes, yes or no?
You accused me of having anti-Semitic and bigoted remarks, and I don't believe any of that. You're
why did you
what
call Nealon your hero?
Why don't you believe what I say, what I mean?
Why did you call Nealon your hero?
He was complimented by a lot of people.
Why did you call him your hero?
It was because he took on Paul Ryan, and I don't support Paul Ryan.
But what about his ugly views? So it doesn't matter who he is or what he believes?
He came out with his views. How many times do we have to discuss this? You know, why would people be watching your show? We're going around in this circle. I've already explained
that. We're
going
to keep going like a merry-go-round until it stops and you admit the truth.
You can do that if you want. I'm glad for the time.
But
you're helping me with my name recognition. That's wonderful.
But
I mean,
what is your name attached to?
What I've said a number of times.
A known anti-Semite? A guy who says that Arthur Ashe is offensive to his heritage?
Everybody complimented him. At the time that he was complimented by me, the
late Phyllis Schlafly,
and several others.
Put back up the timeline.
Several others. He was not. He
Here's
came out
timeline.
With all those crazy ideas much later. And
2016.
For those other comments that he may have made, I don't know. I was certainly not aware of those at that time.
Oh, really?
It was
He's a personal hero of yours, but you didn't know what he was saying?
That everybody says who I meet with? I mean, really? This is the guilt by association. This
yeah,
is McCarthyism.
Guilt by association, 100%.
You know, this
guilt
is McCarthyism. You know, the left learned a lot from McCarthy. They're trying to, you know,
McCarthy.
Just that's what you're doing.
McCarthy was mild compared to the guys you're hanging out with, Corey Stewart. The guy that you
Chris,
just took an endorsement
much.
From.
I do like you. You're a nice guy, but you're far left.
Listen.
And you're not fair.
Let's say I'm so far left that I'm almost right. How does that change any of the things I'm asking you about? You didn't rebut a single factual assertion tonight. You didn't
yes, I did.
Condemn
I just got done,
any of the
like
things that you
times.
Had that you had previously said or done. Not one of them. And yet, the president of the United States thinks that you should be the senator for Virginia.
You know something?
You'll agree with that, won't
this,
you?
This, you know, when you're losing the argument, you know what you do? You know what the left does? They play the race card. They play the race card. We have a president.
You don't think that card applies to the people that you've hung
that
out with a Confederate flag waving around?
Through the biggest tax cut since 1986. The economy is thriving.
Yes.
Unemployment is the lowest that it's been since the early 1970s.
Be nice if
and
wages
what you want to talk
well.
About is what some guy who's no longer relevant said several years ago. That's what you want to talk about. Think about how much of a joke. We have peace breaking out on the Korean Peninsula for the first time since 1950. And you're talking about what Paul Nealon, a failed lunatic, said several
because
years ago.
Because you called him your personal hero.
That's
and you've got a guy who worked
things,
on his
Chris,
staff
you know
working
that.
On your campaign right now. You've got one of his guys on your team. And you just took an endorsement for someone who says Arthur Ashe is disrespectful to
I don't
his heritage.
You know what?
Those are the
people
facts.
Can come out. What if, look, people, all kinds of people come out and support my campaign. I don't go through the entire list. There's
you know
hundreds
exactly
of
who these people are. You
there
walk
are hundreds,
past a Confederate flag to take
case,
his endorsement,
Chris.
And now you won't own
have
it
you ever
because
run a
you
campaign?
Think
I don't think you ever have. You
not one like
of
yours.
People supporting your
Listen.
Campaign. You don't go through the list and find, and you don't do a background check on everybody who endorses your
you
campaign.
You call them your personal hero. You've got a guy working for you that you know worked for Nealon because he worked for you before he worked for Nealon. This is silly. This interview's done. Corey Stewart, I gave you a chance to own what you've done in the past. We'll see how the election goes for
You're
you.
You're too much, Chris.
Listen,
thanks,
it's about
though.
The truth and owning what things are, especially when the president wants to get behind someone.
It's good
like
entertainment
you.
On CNN, folks.
Well, it's entertaining to you. It's truth for the rest of us. Take care.